والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. My dear brothers and sisters, after the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he left Mecca, he left his home, he left his family, he left his tribe. And in fact, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam made the journey from Mecca to Medina, just on the outskirts of Mecca, he turned around and faced the city. And he said that if it wasn't for my people, that I would have never left you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam addressed Mecca al-Mukarramah, the purest place on earth, the place where Ibrahim alayhi wasallam established ibadah, established the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he made the hijrah and he made that journey sallallahu alayhi wasallam to al-Madinah and began a new life with the Ansar, with the helpers and the Muhajirun in al-Madinah al-Munawwara. Previously it was called Yathrib before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam actually entered into Medina. And when the Prophet alayhi wasallam entered into Medina, he called it Al-Madina or Tayyibatu Tayyibah, the purest of purest places. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam began settling in, establishing the masjid, establishing the new society with the Muslims, it was upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam then to start establishing Islam, not just within Medina, but within the surrounding areas. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam addressed the Muhajirun, those who emigrated from Mecca and then started a new life in Al-Madina, how they were going to take their lives forward and start a new life. News reached them that Abu Sufyan, who was one of the main chieftains of Mecca, that he was on a part of a large caravan, a business caravan, and doing lots of trade in Asham, in Syria, in Palestine area. And no doubt that lots of the property that belonged to the Muslims was part of this trade caravan. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam addressed the Muhajirun that it was an opportunity for them, a chance for them to reclaim their wealth. They left the vast majority of their wealth in Mecca that was now being taken and being sold off in another place. The Prophet alayhi wasallam asked the Muhajirun if they wanted to take the opportunity, or that they should take the opportunity, of reclaiming their wealth. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam spoke to the people of the Muhajirun, and they agreed that they wanted to intercept this particular trade caravan that was led by Abu Sufyan, and that they would reclaim their wealth. Then after that, Abu Sufyan heard of what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was planning, and he returned to Mecca on a different route, so he escaped them. However, a large amount, a large group of the mushrikun remained in a certain area. This news reached Abu Jahl. Now Abu Jahl, who was a staunch enemy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said to the people that we cannot have Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his followers behaving like this, that we should raise up an army, raise a jaysh, and we should go out and we should fight the Muslims. This was in the second year of the hijrah, i.e. after 2 years of the Prophet ﷺ arriving in Medina, there was going to be the first main clash, the first encounter between Iman and Kufr, between belief and disbelief, between the Muslims and the disbelievers in an area called Al-Badr. Now this particular battle, it took place on the 17th of Ramadan. It's a blessed month. And the reason, as we mentioned, that the Prophet ﷺ wanted for the companions to reclaim their wealth. Now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companions, that they were only few in number, the majority of them being from the Ansar, but the agreement was that when the Prophet alaihi wasallam arrived in Medina, that they were to have protection, and that it was only upon the Muslims, i.e. the Ansar, to defend the Muslims and defend their own land. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam addressed the Muslims, he specifically addressed the Muhajirun, because they had an agreement to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wherever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would be. However, the Prophet ﷺ was indirectly speaking to the Ansar as well, whether they would participate in the battle or reclaiming the wealth of the Muhajirun and the Muslims. And one of the leaders of the tribes of the Ansar, whose name was Sa'd ibn Ubadah, and also Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, these were the two leaders or the two chieftain tribes of Aus and Khazraj. Both of these tribes embraced Islam. Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, he said, "Ya Rasulullah, it is as though that you are also including us in the conversation." And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "That is the case." And it is known that Sa'd ibn Mu'ath radiallahu anh, he said, O Messenger of Allah, we believe in you, we declare your truth, we witness that you have brought what you have brought is also the truth, and we have given our word and our agreement to hear and obey you. So wherever you are going to go, we will go. And we will not say, as Banu Israel said to Musa, اذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا إن هاهنا قاعدون. That Banu Israel, when Musa alayhi salam was commanded to go into the city, Bayt al-Maqdis, what did they say to him? What did they say to Musa alayhi salam? His people said, you, O Musa and your Lord, you go and fight, we are waiting here. However, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, we will never say that. Rather, we will say, we will go with you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we will fight together. Even if it meant that we were to go out into the sea and fight with you, we will go and do that. So the Muslims, alhamdulillah, all of them, they all agreed to go with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam out and to meet the enemy on the battlefield in an area called Badr, which is approximately 120 kilometers away from Al-Madinah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam managed to only get about 70 from the Muhajirun, because they weren't that many in number, and the majority of them were from the Ansar, split between Al-Aws and Al-Khazraj. From them were, of course, the Khulafa al-Rashidun, Ali radiallahu anhu, and Uthman, and Umar, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhum, the well-known companions. From them who were slightly older in age, slightly younger in age, ill-equipped, all they could muster together to prepare themselves, they numbered approximately 313 or 314, not very many, subhanallah. The disbelievers, on the other hand, were about 1,000 strong, and that they had 70 camels, and they had many horses, subhanallah, wearing full chain metal, led by Abu Jahl. On the night before the battle, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded the Muslims that they would remain in a particular place. And one of the companions, whose name was Al-Hubab ibn al-Munzir radiallahu anhu, he said, O Messenger of Allah, us remaining in this place here, is this a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are you commanded to do this? Or is this your own kind of own order, your own decision to stay here? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it's my own decision, my own ra'i to stay here. Al-Hubab radiallahu anhu, he said, O Messenger of Allah, I believe personally it is better that we should camp in a different area, for that will be better for us, so that we can cut off the water source between us and the enemy. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam took the ra'i, or took the position of Al-Hubab radiallahu anhu, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed them in the place that they stayed in, because on that particular night Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down rain. And the place that the mushrikun that they were staying in, that the land became unsettled, and that they were not able to rest properly, and then they also moved. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed the believers to rest and to take a good rest that particular night in preparation for the battle. No doubt we can see here, subhanallah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was preparing and blessing the believers for victory even before the battle actually occurred. And we know that on the particular battle, when it started on the day that the Muslims, they put forth, and it was the tradition of that time, they would choose three of their best fighters, and similarly the mushrikun placed three of their best fighters as an almost like an introduction to the battle. Walillahi alhamd that the Muslims defeated all of those three mushrikun, and the battle started. About 70 of the mushrikun were killed in that battle, and from them the Fir'aun of this ummah. That was Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl was killed in the Battle of Badr, and 14 companions radiallahu anhum were martyred at this particular battle, the Battle of Badr. This is, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it, Yawm al-Furqan. This is a day of the differentiation between al-haqqi bil-batil, between truth and falsehood. And this is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in a number of ayat in the Quran. For example, in Surah Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, وَلَقَدَ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ وَأَنْتُمْ أَذِلَّهُ فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already made you victorious at Badr, when you were just a weak, small amount in number. So fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much, that you may be grateful. And then the verses continue where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent angels down to aid and to help the Muslims defeating the Mushrikun. This was a crushing defeat, a crushing defeat for the Mushrikun, and they returned to Mecca crushed and defeated in a very, very bad way. And this was a great victory for Islam. This was a great victory for the Muslims. And we should take point from this, that victory is never by numbers. We know that victory is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give victory to many people, many factions and people, even though they may be small in number. If they are attached and close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they will overcome and they will defeat, even if it is a great number of, or great number, great armies and great in great numbers. And we know throughout Islamic history during the Khilafah of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, that there would be many battles that the Muslims would participate in against the Romans, and that the Muslims, subhanAllah, would be very much the minority, maybe 10 or 15, 20,000 strong, and they would be fighting against, subhanAllah, maybe an army of strong of 150,000 or 200,000. And similarly against the Persians, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to the Muslims, walillahil hamd. We also take great lesson for those people who rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are following what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His commands in the Quran and Sunnah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them victory for wherever they are. This was a great battle, and this was the beginning of some great things for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Muslims that they would look forward to, even though some trials would come even just the following year. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established Islam on earth through these individuals. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made sincere dua for on the night before and on the day of Al-Badr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be sincere in our supplications. Allahumma ameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us victory wherever you are. Ameen. Barakallahu feekum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.